everybody. My name is Keisha Devaney. I'm an artist here in New Jersey. And welcome to my video that is showcasing the release of my new stencils through Stencil Girl. My stencils are called Unilumes, which are mystic symbols. And I've also added words to them. In this video, I will be using a few of the stencils in my art journal. And I'll also be giving you tips on how to reuse old artwork to create a quick page in your journal. And then there'll be some video of me just sort of playing in the journal. And, you know, as journaling goes, you're not quite sure where it's headed. So it's kind of fun to watch the process and see where the pages end up at the end. So I hope you enjoy the video and I'll see you soon. Take care. Hey everyone, I'm gonna be doing a project in my art journal, and I'm gonna be doing a couple different things. So we're just gonna go step by step and I'll show you the progress and my intention for using the stencils. So first I just wanted to start off by showing you the stencils. So this is the first one. And then this is the second one. So I think I'm gonna actually use this one because I want a word to be in my journal piece. And I'm gonna use this piece of copy paper. I don't have any molding paste on hand, but I do have this Alex Plus Speckling left over from my bathroom project. And after it dries, it's very similar to using molding paste. So I'm gonna use a hotel key card and I'm just going to start spreading it on. I also go in the other direction as well, so that every little area gets hit. And try not to go super flat like that, because a lot of times that pulls the spackle out. So you kind of want to hold the key card up a little bit so it fills in those spaces. Almost using the edge of the card versus flat. And as I work around the stencil or move around the stencil, I also move my hand so that I can press the stencil down and keep it flat, keep it from moving around. I use this for another project as well, where I was using ink sprays, and sometimes that spray will mix with the spackle, and that's fine. Okay, so then you can remove the stencil. And then give that a rinse so that the spackle doesn't dry in the stencil. And then you're going to be left with this. Pretty cool, huh? So this needs to be set aside and let it dry for a couple hours. And it depends really where you live. Like right now it's January, so I know this is going to need a little bit more drying time since it's chillier. All right, I'll be right back and we'll move on to the next step. Okay, my paper is dry and I just let it dry overnight because I'm going to be using watercolors on these next and I wanted it to be really good and dry. And the reason I'm using copier paper is because I'm going to end up cutting out the word that I use and then gluing it into my journal. And I didn't want to be having it on a thicker paper. I just wanted it on a thin piece of paper that would glue down pretty easily. So I'm going to get out my watercolors. I like to use these watercolors called Fine Tech. And they're very shimmery. Okay. And I think I'm going to use this word that says hope. In color. I'm not sure what color I want. Maybe I always gravitate towards a turquoise. Just giving it a nice coverage, and then I'll take my blow dryer and dry it. Now, I'm not sure if I'll cover this with another color later, which I tend to do, but I also want to mix in some pink. All right, so I am going to blow this dry. I'll be right back. Okay, so we're moving on to the journal part. Got out my journal, and here's this piece. I cut it away from the others. And one thing about myself is that I work intuitively, and I felt like I wanted to outline it in black. And then eventually I'm gonna cut it closer to the edge when I start to glue it down. So I'm kind of wanting to draw or do a journal spread with a girl. That's what I typically like to do. And some things that I wanted to show you first for ideas is I like to make copies of old artwork. So here's a bunch of faces that I painted, and then I'll go up to my copy machine and I'll make copies of them. And so I always have a face ready to go. I have so many different choices here. Here's a piece of deli page that I did, and I kind of was thinking I would use those flowers somehow. This is another copy of a journal page, and I just took it in case I want to use the background for a dress. So here's copies of the faces. I did them in black and white and color in case I wanted to paint on top of this instead of having it already colored in. Here's another face I could use. This is a girl that I use a lot, so I have a lot of copies of her. I could just, you know, cut her head off and make her a new dress and then add this part to her dress, which is what I'm kind of envisioning. This is a piece I did many years ago, but I always loved the eyes, so I could do, you know, a face and then cut these eyes out on top. Another journal spread. I did this in black and white because I really like this piece that I did here. And this could be cut out, even though it's little, it could be incorporated into the journal page. This is another one that I could copy, use the face if I wanted to. And then some more jelly paper that I had made, which would make a nice background for a dress, like maybe having a dress that's got some of the blue and some of the orange and pattern in it. So those are just some tips that I have for you as far as incorporating old artwork into, so that you can keep reusing them in different ways. So it's going to be fun to see what I actually end up using and doing. Okay, so I cut out a bunch of pieces, and I still don't know which pieces I'm using exactly. I'm just going to do some auditioning because it's all going to depend on scale, the size of the page. This piece is pretty long. Someone's head might be too big. Will I have enough room for a dress? So I really just have to do some auditioning. And by the way, I forgot to mention that, so after I did the watercolor on this, I took my blow dryer to dry out the color, and then I also went over to my iron and turned it upside down, placed a piece of fabric over it, and ironed it flat because it was a little, the paper got a little crinkly. Okay, so there's a tip for you if that happens. So I'm saving this background in case I want to use this for a dress. I'm not quite sure. Definitely want to use this flower, probably up by the hair area. Just get that cut out. Okay, so now I can kind of start playing. You know, like this. So that would be kind of fun and funky, which I like. I have to see though, this piece is pretty long. So I mean, I could make it work. And then I'm gonna be adding a dress so I could see like, how does this look on top here if I turn this fabric into her dress. And I'm just going to grab a pen. So I could definitely make this work. I do like her neck, which has those marks on it. So let me move. Ugh. Let me just. Gonna make the. I could remove some of her hair too and get her up closer to the top. So I'm just going to do like an outline of a dress. And then I can cut that out. Make this side a little wider. Okay, so there's one possibility. We've got this girl. The flower's a bit big for her, but again, I could still do some more trimming. Let's audition how this looks as far as if I use this for her dress. And really not liking that as much as the first one. So I'm gonna go with my intuition and work with this. So this is going to be the journal spread. And then after I do so, and I'm gonna be probably doing some painting and mark making, and then I'll figure out where this girl's gonna go. Oh, we still have one face to work with. Forgot about her. So we have her. That's kind of cute, probably because these two colors are very nicely coordinated. That doesn't necessarily work for the scale of her face. So what I could actually do though is, since I like her and I like the first one, I could have one on each page. And so I'll probably make a copy of this and use the dress twice. So yeah, I've made my decisions and I'll be back.